And Union Forest Minister Prakash Javrekar, along with the Minister of State Babul Supriyo, on Monday attended a meeting of all state forest ministers through video conferencing at the Pryavaran Bhavan in the national capital. The meeting focused on enhancing forest quality and increasing tree cover for maximizing carbon stock. The ministry has taken several initiatives, which includes massive tree plantation, promoting urban forestry through Nagar One scheme, landscape-based catchment treatment of 13 major rivers, the LIDAR-based survey of the degraded forest areas for soil moisture conservation projects, and launch of the National Transit Portal. Union Environment Minister Prakash Javrekar said that the Finance Commission has increased the forest weightage to 10% from earlier 7% and added 80% of the CAMPA funds should be used by states for forest preservation. The Union Minister said that Finance Commission has increased the forest weightage by 10% from the earlier 7%. He added that 80%, as I said, of the CAMPA funds will be used for forest preservation.
और प्रधानमंत्री जी का आदेश है, हम आने वाले 15 दिन में उसकी पूरी रूपरेखा तैयार करेंगे, टाइमलाइन तैयार करेंगे और डॉल्फिन जैसा एक अच्छा जलप, एक तरह से जो मछली के प्रजाति में है लेकिन वो अलग ही है डॉल्फिन, तो डॉल्फिन को संरक्षण और संवर्धन करने का कार्यक्रम हम 15 दिन में सुनिश्चित करके सबके सामने रखेंगे।
The minister mentioned that water and fodder augmentation in the forest will be done for the enrichment of the forest and to prevent man-animal conflict.
Finance Commission ने इस बार फॉरेस्ट का वेटेज बढ़ाकर डिवोल्यूशन में राज्यों को जो पैसा मिलेगा उसमें अपना वेटेज फॉरेस्ट का बढ़ा है और फॉरेस्ट का वेटेज अब 10% हो गया है। सो 10%, अर्लियर इट वॉज 7%, 3% से वो बढ़ा है। इसका मतलब फॉरेस्ट को अब ज़्यादा पैसे मिलने चाहिए, मिलेंगे अगर राज्य सरकार खुद के पैसे लगाएगा तो।
And I said, the minister mentioned that water and fodder augmentation in forest will be done for the enrichment of the forest and to prevent man-animal conflict.
LIDAR surveys will be done so that the watershed in each forest will be identified and will be tracked contour-wise, and all other natural details will you get, and we can decide a good watershed management program. जंगल में पानी चाहिए, अंडरग्राउंड वाटर भी चाहिए, सरफेस वाटर भी बढ़ना चाहिए और उसी से फीड एंड फॉडर ये भी बढ़ेगा और उसी से जंगल के प्राणी जंगल में रहेंगे, दे विल नॉट वेंचर आउट।
And for more on that story, I'm joined by my colleague Tapas Bhattacharya. Tapas, the minister very clearly saying that, man-animal conflict will get reduced if, the resources are given to the forest. And he said he's already made it clear that the forest weightage has been increased. The government is progressively looking at increasing that weightage further.
Right. So, Amrit, the meeting just it seems is going to be over in a very short while from now. And a few things that can be taken from this meeting, some few of the key takeaways. The first one you just mentioned about providing the fodder, reducing the man-animal conflict, providing the water and fodder in the forest area so that the animals do not go out. Remember, the major problem that Environment Ministry is facing regarding the human-animal conflict. Be it tigers, be it lions, be it elephants and other such animals in the vicinity. Now the second point that the minister has quite categorically stated that the CAMPA funds that has been released by the center, 80% has to be used by the states for promoting and for increasing the afforestation of forest. Minister has quite categorically said that the funds have been given to increase the forest cover of India and to reduce reduce the carbon emission and to increase the carbon footprint. So in keeping those things in mind, 80% of the fund has to be used to increase the capacity building. The 20% can definitely be used for other purposes, but the major chunk of that has to be used for that. And another key aspect that the minister has mentioned is about Project Dolphin that is going to come in, that we will see in a couple of weeks time. In fact, in a fortnight time, Project Dolphin is going to be launched, and this is a major thing. Remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his independence speech has already categorically stated that we need to safeguard our animals, and Project Dolphin is one such one such species that we should be looking to safeguard. So in a very short while from now, and in fact 2 weeks from now, the Project Dolphin will kick in, and the states have been told to coordinate with the center to increase its population and make sure that the 3,700 dolphins that are currently right now in India, remember, they are currently in the Gangetic Plains. They are mostly found in the Brahmaputra as well as Ganga's tributaries. So make sure that the whole ecosystem is cleared, and the dolphins given their due recognition in its protection as this project has been launched. So key takeaways are these are some of the key takeaways from this meeting that is going on. In a very short while from now, the minister will come out and will brief us further on this. OP.
Tapas, to promote the forest cover, the plantation, the government is focusing on the Nagar One project, promoting nurseries, tree plantations at the school level. Tell us more about that.
That's right, and Nagar One is a major concept that the ministry has came into consideration. In fact, a few days back in the CAG office in the national capital, urban forest has been given up, and the ministry is very clear that each and every state needs to increase this more concept. Remember, especially in metropolitan cities where the problem of pollution is skyrocketing, especially let's just talk about Delhi, which we have always faced the problem of pollution in our day-to-day life. This urban forest concept will be a game changer, where small areas will be converted into urban forest, and where it will initially the effort will be to increase the indigenous trees, indigenous shrubs of the particular land, and they will act as a lungs of the city, and they will act as a in a way they will help reduce the carbon dioxide. So urban forest Nagar One are going to be the concept to go further, and the ministry believes that this is going to be a game changer in all the states if they can implement it in toto. So we're looking forward to more such urban forest hubs in few days time.
All right, Tapas Bhattacharya, many thanks for joining us. We leave it there. Thank you. And it's time for us to slip into a short commercial break. We'll be back in a little while. Keep watching Metro Prime.